electricity has to travel a long distance before it reaches our home. It is generated in power plants and is transmitted through power lines or transmission lines. In this video, I am going to talk about these overhead transmission lines. Hi, I am Vanilla and you are watching The Learning Curve. To reduce the losses, electricity is transmitted at very high voltages. A transmission line is nothing but a conductor which allows electricity to flow through them easily. The most common conductive material is copper. It also has high tensile strength, which means it can withstand mechanical stress. Therefore, in earlier days, copper is used as an electrical transmission line material. However, nowadays we are using aluminium instead of copper. Do you know why? Even though the conductivity and the tensile strength of aluminium are less compared to the copper, the cost and the weight of aluminium are low. The transmission line should have high tensile strength because it has to withstand heavy rain and wind. So, to increase the tensile strength of the aluminium, steel is added to it. If we are using a single solid conductor, then it is very difficult to coil the conductor. I mean, it will not be flexible. Is that a problem? The problem comes when we need to transport a lengthy solid conductor over a long distance. Therefore, instead of solid conductor, stranded conductor is used. Here, instead of a single solid conductor, several thin wires called strands are twisted together. The commonly used conductor is aluminium conductor steel reinforced cable. Here, the outer strands are high purity aluminium and the center strand is steel. These transmission lines are supported by transmission towers. The tower is made so tall to maintain a safe distance from the people, animals, and other things. Transmission lines are connected to the tower through insulators. Insulators used for high voltage power transmission are made from glass, porcelain or composite polymer materials. Look at this transmission tower. Here the conductors are simply suspended from the tower. This kind of tower is called a suspension tower. But whenever the transmission line changes direction, we cannot use this transmission tower. In that case, angle towers are used. This means angle towers are used when the transmission line route deviates. If you look carefully at this angle tower, both sides of the tower are connected to the power line through the insulators. Since insulators don't allow current to flow through them, there is no electrical connection between these two power lines. To solve this problem, a jumper is used. A jumper is a conductor that is rated to carry full line current. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you know how many transmission lines a single tower supports? Sometimes we see three conductors and sometimes it is six. Let me explain this. Power plants generate three-phase electricity. Therefore, a single circuit transmission line has three sets of conductors. A double circuit transmission line has two independent circuits. This means it has six conductors. When transmitting at very high voltage, we often use bundled conductors. As I said earlier, each phase has a single conductor. But in bundled conductor, each phase will have multiple conductors. A metallic structure called spacers groups the conductors of each phase. Each phase can have 2, 3, or 4 conductors. We will have 3 such group of conductors in a single circuit transmission and 6 such groups in double circuit transmission. Other than these conductors, another wire is directly connected to the top of the tower. They are called shield wire or earth wire. They are used to protect conductors from direct lightning strike and minimize the possibility of power outages. Have you ever seen some colorful balls in transmission lines? Well, those balls are visibility markers. They are just used for safety purposes. They make the transmission lines visible to low-flying aircrafts like planes and helicopters. That's all for today. If you like this kind of video, I'm sure you like my power grid video. Bye, see you in my next video.